I bought a couple of these cheap hot glue guns recently, and like many other devices these days, this has a non-removable battery and soft power switch. It's just a momentary switch that doesn't actually cut the power, but instead tells the microcontroller to do something, for example, toggle the power. One advantage of this type of power switch is how easy it is to switch this on. However, one disadvantage is how easy it is to switch this on. It can be dangerous if a device that heats up, moves, or makes noise turns on by accident when device is in storage and something accidentally hits the button. To avoid that in my own designs, I made a circuit that has so-called storage mode, which disables the device until the charger is connected. The idea is to have a soft power switch that is easy to use and toggles the output on or off, but only when the storage mode is not activated. Storage mode can be activated when the device won't be used in a while and it will be stored somewhere out of sight. This video is sponsored by PCBWAY.com. These are some of the PCBs they have made. They also do 3D printing and CNC milling in many different materials. PCB, PCBA, 3D printing and CNC milling services. Everything you need for your prototypes, go check out their current offering and pricing at PCBWAY.com. I have owned many devices that should have protection like this. Couple of hot glue guns and cordless rotary tools to mention a few examples. Main parts of my circuit are single cell lithium battery charging module. This one is based on TP4056. Then there's Arduino Nano and a latching relay. Latching relay has two coils and a short pulse is all it needs to set its state to one or the other, based on which coil was energized. This is the usual circuit for powering Arduino from lithium battery using one of these charging modules. This protection circuit adds the latching relay, which cuts the power between module's output and Arduino. Coil that connects the module and Arduino together gets energized from the 5V input, one that powers the charging module when the battery is being charged. The coil that disconnects the power is controlled by one of the Arduino's GPIO pins. It doesn't really matter which 5V powered single cell charging module and which microcontroller is used. This is very universal circuit. As long as microcontroller can be powered from single cell lithium battery and it can output enough current for the relay's coil. In this demonstration, Arduino reads the input from the push button, toggles the LED when battery is pressed, and turns the GPIO pin going to the relay high if the button is pressed longer than the preset threshold duration. When the pin going to the relay goes high, relay will toggle, disconnecting the power from the Arduino. Relay being latching type, it won't automatically return to the previous state. The other coil has to be energized to get the power back to the Arduino. That only happens when the 5V is connected to the input of charging module. The code used in this demonstration isn't ready-made code for any final product. It doesn't utilize low power modes or interrupts or anything like that. It's just a quick simple code that can demonstrate this one concept. Like always, there isn't just one way of doing things. The storage mode or protection could be done in microcontroller's firmware. If instead of using relay, the microcontroller reads the status of 5V input using GPIO pin. Microcontroller would block the output if the storage mode is activated and disable the storage mode when the 5V is present at the charging module's input. Adding a relay increases cost, but in many cases it can be preferred to have the output physically disconnected. Microcontroller isn't then powered in the storage mode, and therefore it can't accidentally disable the storage mode due to a malfunction. I tried to keep this circuit and code simple. It really doesn't matter what the Arduino's output controls. It's up to you. The code handles just a couple of outputs and input. It can be done with pretty much any kind of microcontroller. No special peripherals is needed. Do you prefer modern soft switches or actual physical toggle switches? Have you had incident of device turning on by accident? Share your thoughts in the comments. See you next video. Thanks.